This is TWiT.
Hybrid work, where Microsoft Microsoft, like everybody else, is saying, don't come back to work now, right?
Yeah. I know, but they just spent the past year talking about how, oh, it's great, hybrid work, we got this, blah, blah, blah. And then they did a survey with their employees and like, oh, we got to get back to the office. this is not.
Well, this was a surprise because everybody else is saying, oh, it's good. Workers are happier. They do a better job. Mm. Microsoft's study says what? They don't.
Right.
It says that people are relying on what they call asynchronous ways of communicating. So emails, you know, what else? Chat, that kind of stuff. And they want them to be using Teams and video and synchronous methods of communication because they have made the case that this is better for productivity. And they're like, oh, wait, we did a survey of our employees and they're all in these silos doing all these private emails and private chats and SMS. And that's not what we want. And so it's making them less productive. I'm like,
that's what people do.
Which came first, the study or the decision to not let people stay home?
Yeah, right.
Right.
Well, okay. I mean, I hopefully the decision had more to do with just the.
I know it does. It does. COVID. Right.
But you know how this thing goes. Should, you know, if you
no. No, we should bring that up, right? So Microsoft, for the past year, they've been giving dates of this is the earliest return date for our U.S. employees. And the last one we had was early October. And then this week they just blew that up and they said, you know what? We're not going to even try to predict when the new return date is. We'll see. So, yeah. They're not even saying like January or anything. They're just saying we're going to wait and look at the science. And
they've changed it four times already, right?
They have.
So I think like April, June, September, October, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep. Right.
And you know, there's, I guess there are people who don't understand science out in the world or something, but there's, you know, here we are. We should have been over it by now and we're not. So
So this was a peer reviewed study. It wasn't just like, hey, let's send out something on Teams and get everybody's opinion. 61,000 employees was from Microsoft Research. They published it in the Journal of Nature and Human Behaviour. And of course, at the same time as they said this, they said, oh, and don't come back. It feels like it's a little self-serving to say you should be using Teams. Okay, can I just say?
I know.
Well, this is based on Microsoft employees, right? So, in other words, this is not a survey of other employees. These are Microsoft employees, right? And so what they've discovered is that even within Microsoft, people are just engaging in these non-new normal communication types, which is what people do, you know? Even in small companies like mine, everyone has probably noticed this. You throw something into a group chat and it devolves into pictures of someone's vacation.
Yeah.
And it's like,
yeah,
but what about that work thing I was trying to get done?
I hate that, to be honest with you.
Yeah, and I think for...
I told you, I'm the bad guy who banned animated GIFs in our Slack.
Yeah. No, there's a place for that kind of stuff. Don't get me wrong. But sometimes to get something done, you need to go to the individual that will help you get it done and just communicate privately. And of course, now there's like, well, you communicated privately. What are you doing? What about the rest of us? It's like, I just wanted to get it done, not see pictures of your kid.
Purely anecdotally. So this is why it's hard to compete with a 61,000 person survey published in a Journal of Human Behavior, et cetera, et cetera. But purely anecdotally, my experience has been no one wants to come back to the office.
Yes.
They miss the people. And if you had a weekly lunch, that'd be more than adequate. And the rest of the time, they're very happy to be working at home. And I have to say, our experience with our remote workers has been pretty good.
Yeah,
I think, it depends. If people are getting the job done, that's fine. And that's been the bar for people like Mary Jo and I for a long time. Like, no one has to question whether we're working. You can see what we're doing.
Yeah, we have a product that we put out. Now, notice I, who could very easily do what the rest of our hosts are doing and work from my home office, come in.
Right. Sure.
And so I guess I'm the counterexample to that, but, you know, I haven't.
Well, but you know, the exception proves the point. I mean, you are alone in the studio for the most part.
And so. I can just close my doors. I get the best of both worlds, right?
Yeah. Well, it also creates a sense of continuity for the company.
Right. But it also depends on what your setup is, right? Like, so we like working at home because we've found a way to make it work in our home office environments, right? There are a lot of people
Joe, if you don't mind, real quick. Yes. We work at home because we hate people. But go on.
Well, also that, too. But in well, that. If,
there is a higher percentage of misanthropy among TWiT hosts than the
yes,
average
I'm sure.
population.
I'm sure there is.
Well, there's a reason we ended up in this bucket.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, so we're the wrong people to ask, obviously.
No, but think if you're somebody who has like young children at home who haven't been going to school,
right.
Your spouse works at home, you work at home, and you live in like 800 square feet in New York or less, you probably
right.
are not as
experience.
Excited yeah. to be at home, yeah. and you're happy to be going back yeah. to the office. Right?
But if your husband goes back to the office and your kids go back to school,
then you have it all to yourself.
I think staying home sounds pretty good.
You won. And by the way, that you just defined my career for the first 20 years.
Yeah.
It was wonderful.
Yeah. Working from home yeah. is fine. It's the problem is people, wherever you are.
Mm-hmm.
So if yeah. you can find a nice, quiet place to get your job right. done. What yeah. does this do
Although,
for things
know,
like WeWork? I mean...
It, right. Yeah. They're having trouble keeping people, right? But in the same breath, Microsoft is setting up these like hot desking situations. So there
sounds,
is a place for people to come in.
That sounds
and
like the worst
work.
Of both worlds.
Well, actually,
no,
that,
you know
what
like, come in,
like
come in 2 days a week.
WeWork and bringing it to work.
Right.
You know,
come in 2 days a week. You have a desk you can use that you can, when you sign in, it has all your stuff. When you leave, all your stuff is gone from yeah. from the monitor and the computer, right? And that's kind of the best of all worlds, right? You have your group meeting, you come in, you do it, and then you go home and you work the rest of the time at home.
Right.
I think that's right. good. I wouldn't mind doing
I'm
that.
I'm going to propose something. I think what's changed is it used to be the internet was better at work, not anymore. It sure. used to be you had better hardware, computers, technology at work, not anymore.
Right, right. Mm-hmm.
So now you can easily, in a home office, most people who work at home or ever have worked at home have very competent setups. Mm-hmm. So that's solved. What you don't have is the idiot coworker who comes over every 5 minutes to look over your cubicle and say, what you're doing. You don't have the meetings, the incessant meetings, which no one likes.
Well, except we do.
No, you have them on Teams.
And they're worse.
Right.
You know, that's honestly the worst part about working.
Actually, that is. You're right.
Right.
Meetings
yeah. no,
follow
you know,
everywhere.
You know what we don't have, though, as journalists? And I'm sure there are examples outside of journalism, too. You can't have the same like camaraderie and... kind of environment that when you're working with a source virtually versus in person.
Yeah, that's true.
I was trying to explain to someone, I'm like, drinks over the internet,
no beer.
Like,
are, yeah.
it's not the
oh,
same
it's not,
thing. Like,
it's not
right?
even in the same.
And no. of course, we're talking about knowledge workers here. We're not,
yes,
obviously,
right.
there are, you know, there are people who have to go to a factory. There's yeah. people, our engineers.
A restaurant
have,
or a
restaurant.
Whatever
exactly.
Yeah.
Yep. But I think the point is that there's an industrial era notion that you work 9 to 5 Monday through Friday, kind of like you had to go to assembly line of information.
That is absolutely, yeah. Yep.
And that's antiquated.
Yep.
That's Henry Ford mm-hmm. thinking.
The other, you mm-hmm. can't unbite the forbidden fruit either. I think
that's
a big
right.
part of it. These yeah. people have been home now for a year. They've made it work. And the thought of getting on that train and spending 40 minutes every
right.
day getting to work or whatever your commute is suddenly not just just something I do every day. It's something I can't, it's like I can't do this anymore. Mm-hmm. You know, I think they've, you know, and again, I just want to issue a complaint about that. I've been doing this for 25 years. I want you all to go back to work.
Paul's been biting that forbidden fruit for 20 years,
This
baby.
Is my fruit. Go to work.
We act as if everybody can do this. Obviously, everybody can't do this. But
yeah.
but for information workers, for knowledge workers, I think it makes sense to let them work. They have a task to do, right? And if they get it done,
right.
that's what matters.